Hello, hello! Big day! We have lots of people here to announce today. First, a word from our Dean, Zach.
Hello, good afternoon, everyone. Some of you I may have had the pleasure of running into and getting the chance to meet so far this summer. Otherwise, I hope to meet everyone and say hello. I just want to go over a couple of things about the amphitheater that we should all be doing on a daily basis to make sure that we enjoy the show to its fullest extent. So while you are in the amphitheater, from the moment you step into the amphitheater, so before you're in your seat, your cell phone should be in your bag. There's no cell phone time. Even when you're in the amphitheater, it's part of your audience etiquette to be in your seat and ready for the show to start without your cell phones. There's no food of any kind, even snacks. If you need to take a sip of water, take it quickly before the show starts, and please put your bottle back in the bag so it doesn't fall and make a lot of noise. This should also be, this is not the time to read books, this is not the time to complete projects for another class, this is the time to sit up, give all of your attention forward. Anything you need to say to a friend can wait till after the performance. So when we have you here for the amphitheater to attend a performance, you should be sitting up straight, focused on the stage, no phones, books, water bottles, food. All right, and with all of those things combined, we will have a wonderful performance. We'll enjoy the show. So thank you guys for adhering to that.
Thank you, Zach. So a few announcements. First, today is the last day for some of our students in the week two rec camp. And we'd love to acknowledge you. And if you're comfortable, please stand up. So if you're Jaslyn, Kayla, Jacqueline, Kevin, Wade, Amalia, Callista, Bryn, Julia, or Madeline, please stand up. Where are you? Thank you for being part of our community. We're really grateful you were here this week. And now we have Cora, Elizabeth, Carolyn, Miriam, and Misha to announce our staff festival. Oh, Cora first has an announcement.
Happy Decades Day. If you are wearing an outfit tributed to a specific decade, please stand up. Okay, that's a lot.
Oh, look at all
that's a lot people. More people than I saw.
And now you can sit down.
Thank you. So I've been studying theater since kindergarten, and I love to dance and sing, so kind of mash it all together. And I'm also very sarcastic, and like I love to act. So, and we're also both in Mary Poppins.
And I've only been studying theater for a couple years, but I already love it.
Okay, so next is about our performers. I love our performers because they're all really good at theater. Like, Spencer and James put on the best shows, and Kyra is so good at choreographing things, and I love theater too, so.
Okay, all of them went here, and now they work here. Please give a warm welcome to our own Voices of Broadway!
Are warm and dry. Now is the time to run. it's gonna rain.
I can see it.
Soon it's gonna rain.
I can tell.
Soon it's gonna rain. What are we gonna do? Soon it's gonna rain. I can feel it. Soon it's gonna rain. I can tell. Soon it's gonna rain. What'll we do with you?
We'll climb the four limbs of a tree. We'll build four walls and a floor. We'll bind it over with leaves, then duck inside and stay.
Then we'll let it rain, we'll not feel it. Then we'll let it rain, rain pell mell, and we'll not complain if it never stops at all. We'll live and love within our own four walls.
Thank you. Thank you so much, everyone. Hi, I am Kyra Leeds, and these are my really good friends, Spencer Glass and James Crichton. Thank you. And we are all professional actors, but we are also, like, as was said earlier, current staff members. So I work in the main office. I am the community relations coordinator, and James and Spencer both work in the theater department as directors this summer.
Woo!
I know, snaps. And what's the coolest part about us, though, is that we all met while we were students at Usdan, just like you all. And I was a couple of grades below Spencer and James, and so the fact that I'm doing this with them today is amazing because I truly looked up to them my whole life. They were in troupe ahead of me. Like, this is just the coolest thing in the world. And it goes to show, you never know. These friends that you are making this summer, down the line, years from now, you might be doing a festival performance with them as well, so that's pretty cool. Today, what we chose to sing first was Soon It's Gonna Rain, and that is from The Fantastics. And we chose that song to honor the theme this summer of water. And, oh wait, Spencer, didn't you want to say something? Yeah.
What do I want? Well, ever since I was a little boy, there's always been one thing I want. I want what every little red-blooded boy in America could want. I want what I have wanted since the first day I knew how to want. I want to be a rocket. And it's no surprise. I wanna be a rocket. Oh, how my foot is gonna rise. Now I wanna be a rocket. It's the one thing I know. And when I'm a rocket, I'll never miss one show. I'll show 'em. I never wanted to be a Broadway star. Being famous has too many duties. I never wanted to be a ballet star. I always wanted to be one of those dazzling dancing beauties. I'll always remember when Mama brought me to New York and I first saw those girls up on that stage. There was magic everywhere. Look at them, Mama, I said. One of those days, your little boy's gonna be up there. he's gonna beat up them. I'm not done. I'm gonna be a rocket. Let me out on that stage. I'm gonna be a rocket. They are the greatest dancers of our age. I'm gonna be a rocket. I'm gonna hear the crowd scream. I wanna know the feeling of getting my dream. And that is my dream, to know how it feels to be up on that stage and to kick up my heels. It's what I was meant to be. You gotta take me, gotta take me, gotta take me, gotta take me, gotta take me. Everybody, I'm Spencer Glass. I am directing in the theater department this summer, Crazy for You. That was a song called I Want to Be a Rockette. Now, though I actually do not have aspirations to specifically want to be a Rockette in my life, this song is so special to me because it is about following your dreams. And you will hear this over and over again growing up, but it's so important to really zone in on what you want, guys, and fight for that. And at Usdan, I went here for 7 summers. That is where I discovered what my dream was, which is to be an artist, which is to be part of this incredible, incredible community of musicians and dancers and writers and everything. And so I learned this song when I was at Usdan. And every time I sing it, it reminds me of my love for musical theater and for this camp. So, with that said, let's go to the next song. You guys are about to hear from James Crichton, who is doing a fabulous job on the keys, am I right? James, who is also part of the theater department here, he's been here forever. He's also my best friend of 20 plus years. We met here at Usdan. Oh my gosh. He is going to sing a Jason Robert Brown, who wrote 13 the Musical. He is going to sing Someone to Fall Back On by Jason Robert Brown, the incomparable James Crichton.
Kamikaze fighter, don't count on me to storm the barricades and take a stand or hold my ground. You'll never see any scars or wounds. I don't walk on coals, I don't walk on water. Well, I am no prince, I am no saint, I am not anyone's wildest dream, but I can stand behind and be someone to fall back on. Some comedy. Like a waste of time, like it serves no purpose. I am take your side if I'm the only one. I'm used to that. I've been alone. I'd rather be the half of us, the least of you, the best.
Thank you. Just a little bit of a downer after Spencer's Rockette song. But I wanted to sing this song today because, like Spencer said, we met here in the early 2000s. And in 2002, specifically, there was a production of Kiss Me, Kate that happened in the troupe, the troupe's production of Kiss Me, Kate. And at the time, there was, the musical director's name was Annie Pasqua. And I was in fifth grade, and I was seated right next to where Annie was conducting the band and playing the piano. And I loved the show, and the show was magic to me, and I loved being an actor, but I couldn't help but look over at Annie throughout the whole performance and watch how she conducted and led the band, but also was a fearless musician. And that summer sort of led me down a path to learn how to kind of follow in her footsteps and learn how to do what she did. So it really is quite an honor to be playing the piano that she used to play all the time and to be doing it here in front of all of you. And Jason Robert Brown was one of the first composers when I was a kid at Usdan that it was really cool if you brought in your vocal selection books from a Jason Robert Brown musical and could play it. So he was one of the first people that made me really want to focus on singing and playing the piano at the same time. But yes, so I am directing a production of Pal Joey this summer at Usdan. I'm also directing, co-directing a production of Seussical, and I am teaching a skill class. And this is my 17th summer in total, so it's a pleasure to be here. Thank you. And now, without any further ado, I have my friend Miss Kyra Leeds, who I remember quite fondly playing Janet Vandergraff in The Jazzy Chaperone.
Thank you, James. That was gorgeous. So I'm going to sing a song today from Funny Girl, but it's not Rain on My Parade. This song takes place at the beginning of the show, before anyone knows who Fanny Bryce is, before she's had her chance to shine, and she is just raring and ready to go. And I think the reason I love this song so much is because of something I found here at Usdan, which is, I feel as though Usdan is such a great place, and I hope you all feel the same way. It really gives us the freedom to find ourselves, to find who we truly are, to gain a supportive network of friends who can support you on your journey. And I love that this song is about a woman who knows exactly what she wants. She has worked hard for it, and now she just needs someone to give her a shot. I've got 36 expressions. Sweet as pie to tough as leather. And that's six expressions more than all those Barrymores put together. Instead of just kicking me, why don't they give me a lift? I think it's a plot, 'cause they're scared that I've got such a gift. Well, I'm miffed, 'cause I'm the greatest star. I am by far. But no one knows it. Wait, they're gonna hear a voice, a silver flute. They'll cheer each toot. Yeah, it's terrific! Woo! When I expose it. Now can't you see the look at me that I
natural Camille. Oh, as Camille, I just feel I have so much to offer. I know I'd be divine because I'm a natural coffer. Oh, oh, some ain't got it, not a lump. I'm a great big clump of talent. Laugh, ha, they'll bend in half. You ever hear the one about the traveling salesman? 1,000 jokes stick around for the jokes. 1,000 faces. I reiterate, when you're gifted, then you're gifted. These are facts. I've got no axe to grind. Hey, what are they, blind? In all of the world so far, I'm the greatest star. Who is that pip with pizzazz? Who is all ginger and jazz? Who is as glamorous as? Who's an American beauty rose with an American beauty nose and 10 American beauty toes? Eyes on the target and wham! One shot, one gunshot and bam! Hey, Mr. Ziegfeld! I can make them sigh. Someday they'll clamor for my drama. Have you guessed yet? Who's the best yet? If you ain't, I'll tell you one more time. You bet your last dime. In all of the world so far, I'm the greatest, greatest star.
You've been amazing. Please give it up for James Crichton on the keys.